Are you a pro developer? Do you know the second principle of the solid principles? Well, if not, then you're in luck, because today we are going to smash that subscribe button, because you are going to learn about the second solid principle, and that is the open-close principle. So let's open up Xcode and let's dive in. The open-close principle is the second one in the solid principles, and today we are going to dive deep into it with the help of an example. But before we do that, let me just remind you about DevFactory, a 60-minute Zoom call with me at rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can ask me questions about Swift, Swift UI, or if you have a bug in your code, I can help you with that. Go ahead and check it out. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. So we are going to tackle the second principle of the solid principles today, and that is the open-close principle. So this is what the solid principles stand for: a single responsibility principle, open-close principle, Liskov substitution, interface segregation, and dependency inversion principles. Now, today I'm going to tackle the open-closed principle, and go ahead and check out the link in the description for the whole playlist where you can learn about all of these principles. It's a whole playlist dedicated just for the solid principles. And today we are going to tackle the second one, and that is open-close. But why do we actually need the solid principles? The solid principles help you solve the main problems of the bad architecture. You most probably know that clean code is the very most important kind of trait of a good software developer. And we are going to tackle fragility, immobility, and rigidity with the solid principles. Now, I talk a lot about this in depth in the first video on the playlist, so go ahead and check that out. But the main important part here is that with following these principles, you will get a maintainable and expandable source code. So yeah, that is what you actually want after 2 or 3 months down the line, once you've written your code. And the first one was the single responsibility principle. We tackled that in the previous video. It's also on the playlist, of course. And today we are going to tackle the open-closed principle. And in brief, it states like entities should be open for extension, but closed for modification. Now, I do know that this is kind of encrypted, so I have created some sort of a definition for this. A class is closed since it may be compiled, stored in a library, baselined, and used by client classes. But it is also open since any new class may use it as parent, adding new features. When a descendant class is defined, there is no need to change the original or to disturb or to disrupt its clients. Now, this is the open-close principles, and we are going to show a bad way of doing things and actually a good way with the solid open-close principle today. So let's dive into our Xcode project. And if you haven't done already so, go ahead and check out the link in the description for this kind of starter project. It's just a set of files. You will see that. And today we are going to tackle the second folder right over here. And as you can see, we have a before and an after file. I'm just going to set up these two files, and I'm going to make functions as file private so I can just reuse them and you will better understand it. And as you can see here, we have some open Wikipedia links where you can read more about this and some sort of a definition. Basically, that's it. Now, let's go into the before of how we would build out this class. And I'm going to create a payment manager so we can have different types of payments. And by the way, all of these before examples, they do work, but they are not extensible and they are not maintainable because they break any of these solid principles. So let's start off with the before of open closed principles example. And I'm going to have a file private function here, a class here. So let's make this a class and let's name this payment manager. And this payment manager will, let's say, make a cash payment. So let's have a func here, make cash payment. Okay, and let's have an amount of double. And yeah, you do whatever you want. Let's just perform here. Okay, so we are going to make actually a cash transaction right over here. But what if you wanted to add in another, like a credit card, like a Visa payment? So let's, you would just go like, have another function, make Visa payment. And again, the amount, and that would be our double. And of course, you would just perform that action also. And this is great. Okay, but this is kind of getting, as you can see, this is kind of getting cumbersome. And we are going to have a lot more if we attempt to have a MasterCard payment. And actually, that is what we want to do next. But let me just show you what the actual principle is. Entities should be open for extension, but closed for modification. And this is fine for now, okay. But what if I, this is version one, and then on version two, I want to add MasterCard. Then this class is not closed for modification. So we are breaking the rule. Okay, so if we wanted to add another one, so let me just copy this out and paste it in here. So let's just go. Now, this breaks the open-close principle, basically the closed part of the open-close principle. So basically, this is not what we want. And the other one is that entities should be open for extension, but closed for modification. So we don't want to let this class as it is to be modified later on. So let me just go into the after. Basically, this is the open, like the before version of our class. It's okay, it will work, but it's not really maintainable and extensible. So let's just go on the after and let's do this kind of the solid way with the open closed principle. So first of all, well, let me just create that file private class. So actually, this is what the class we are trying to create. Now, how would we approach this? Well, there are two things here. We want to make sure that the payment manager will not be modified over time. So we want to have only a kind of like one function right over here. And we want to, on top of that, make it extensible. So here comes the power of protocols. Go ahead and check out my protocols related video on the channel. You will see a link in the description for that also. So we want to create a protocol, and I'm going to name this a payment protocol. Of course, again, a file private protocol, and that payment protocol will have only one requirement, and that's a function, and with the amount of double. Okay, as you see, well, all of those elements did have kind of a way of making a payment. So this is our payment protocol. So now we are going to create separate classes for each of those with that payment protocol that are adhering to this payment protocol. So again, a new file private class, and let's just go cash payment, and we are adhering to our payment protocol, which means that all we have to do is adhere to the make payment. So let's just add these stubs, well, actually only one, and we are just going to perform our cash type of payment. Let me just have that typo fixed. Okay, now what about the Visa payment? Well, it will be kind of the same. So we just go again, file private class, and let's just go Visa payment adhering to our payment protocol. And again, let's just wait. Well, actually, I'm just going to copy this out because the requirement is the same and the perform will be also on the Visa payment. So currently, now we have this, and the payment manager will just have a function called make payment, and of course the amount of double, and the payment type, but let's just call this payment, and that will be our payment protocol. Okay, and now we just go payment dot make payment of that amount. And as you can see, when you choose your payment right over here from the payment protocols, you are going to actually make sure that it performs cash or Visa payment. And let's say, so basically that's it. But now let me just show you how you can extend on this. Let's say this is version 1 and it all goes well. On version 2, we want to add MasterCard. Now, we don't want to actually mess around with the payment manager, meaning that this is closed for modification. We want to extend it, meaning that entity should be open for extension. So let's just create another MasterCard payment. So file private class MasterCard payment adhering to our payment protocol. And again, I'm going to copy the required function out and paste it in there. And now we didn't modify the actual payment manager, but we did extend it. So this is really, really cool. This is how you adhere to the open closed principle from the solid principles. Now, if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a 60-minute Zoom call. If you do have any bugs in your code, if you want to learn Swift or Swift UI, you can meet me there. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. The open close principle is so important for writing extendable code. Now, if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and smash that like button. And while you are at it, make sure to hit that notification bell to get notified of the next video in the series. And that is about the Liskov substitution principle. It's right over here. And if you do want to take a look at the whole playlist about the solid principles, it's right over here. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.